Great morning, everyone. The time is now 8:29, which means I have approximately 30 seconds to prepare you for the great time that you're about to have as we share this promotion day for our 8th grade scholars who will soon move to high school. So before we begin, let's give them a round of applause. But please rise as we have our 8th grade scholars march in. Before we begin, we have a slight issue. Anyone parked going, when you come from 49, that curb going back toward the cafeteria, we need you to move from that area. Our food truck is attempting to make a delivery, and they can't get back there. We would not like for any vehicles to get scratched or anything of that nature. I do apologize. I thought my safety officer was down there keeping that space clear. But if you're parked on the side of the building going back toward the football field, I need you to move that those vehicles at this time so we can get our food truck in here. Thank you.
Good morning to my teachers, my parents, administrators, and my fellow classmates. My name is Jada Prince of ADA Federal School Scholar. I would like to bring you greetings and welcome to our 2022 8th grade class. We've had an eventful 3 years, years that we would never forget. But today, we are celebrating our many successes and accomplishments. So without further ado, let us begin our 2022 class meeting. Thank you.
Thank you.
In August of 2019, I was just a little girl going to the sixth grade. Starting middle school with brand new experiences. I only knew one school my entire life. I had no idea what JPS or middle school are too. I was entering a new environment. One that I didn't know at the time consisted of some of the most talented, artistic, and intelligent scholars in the state. Although things were severely different from what I was used to, I was welcomed by wonderful teachers and leaders. Some of them were 8th graders that I had never raised before, helped me with the same 6th and 7th graders in this school. I am thankful for my 6th grade teachers who have anchored me and my classmates in middle school future. And even though our time is cut short, I enjoy having you all that's right. Well, we all know 7th grade girls in Paragraph. Our school is virtual, the first of all. Thank you to our teachers who gave us great education over the computer in the middle of the pandemic. However, with all persisting in the past, they can get to where we are today. Entering 8th grade was fairly similar to the 6th grade. I was entering a contrasting environment under new leadership and guidelines after being at home for roughly 2 years. After quarantine, I'm pretty sure we were all ready to go back to someplace new, a place that will bring us memories of the 6th grade day. In a building where we only want to down the hill to travel to our APAC courses. That's just comfortable to us, and someplace we knew. Yet another problem call, we were informed that we had to merge with another middle school while our building is being renovated. Two separate middle schools in one building. But hey, nothing we can say. We're surviving this entire school year in the middle of the pandemic. I think they can tell us the next school is in space, and we will be all right. And I can't let this moment go by without thanking our 8th grade teachers for pushing us to do our very best and preparing us for high school. Thank you. Starting 8th grade off in different circumstances, everyone has to get reacquainted with many things. For some of us, we've been in classes together with the same people since 6th grade. For others, even before then. But this year, most people travel to classes with the same people. Allowing connection to it, like a family, full of laughter, fun memories, and sometimes even friendly disagreements. It's with this and more that I decided to run for office. I wanted to make all students' voices heard, giving my peers a platform to express their opinions. My goal was to, and still is, to create a better change for Bailey APAC Middle School. Being right here, speaking to y'all, makes it real. We're at the end. We've been a long way, as evident to we do have a long way to go. As we finish eighth grade, leaving our middle school legacy behind, we are about to embark on a new journey. Starts a new chapter in high school. Some of us will be together, others are going to go separate ways. Maybe you're tired of hearing you survived middle school through a global pandemic, but let's face it, we did survive middle school through a global pandemic. Not even having the chance to finish sixth grade, but we're still right here at the finish line. And there's no class I'd rather be here. A thank you to all of my teachers over the last 3 years for guiding my classmates and me through our middle school journey. And thank you to my classmates. I love you all, and I wish you all the absolute best. Thank you.
As we leave these walls, let us not leave each other. Let us remember each other in prayer and always give thanks for every moment we share as a night. In closing, remember, once a night, always a night. Thank you, Bailey Class of 2022.
To come out of every Awards to the top three students in Granite High School literacy. All of them had an A average and they were separated by tenths of points. Our third highest average, Mackenzie Watson. have the top three scholars in physical education. With the third highest average, Nicholas Carr.
average of 98.2, Shelby Walker. Let's celebrate our scholars and scholars.
Clock and they will receive the awards then, but I do want to recognize them at this time. Also, I want the scholars from all the band schools to remember that an ounce of self-discipline saves tons of regret. There's some quotes that I would always tell them. Also, that do what's hard so your life will be easy, because if you do what's easy, you make your life hard. Because the hard will soon become very easy. And always give love. We can go without food, we can go without water for so many days, but we all need love. And if someone loves you, they will give you food and they will give you water. Congratulations. The top three scholars are in third place, Justin Hollywood. Our second scholar is Carla Cobo. And our first place scholar is
Samaje Jones.
Good morning. You don't have to speak, but Ms. Wright is going to find out. I'm here to give the award for highest average in Spanish. Our third highest average, 97, is Clarissa Coleman. Our second highest average of 97.3 is Marlene Johnson. And first place average of 97.3 is Mary. All of the students who work so diligently. I know my class wasn't as quick as the easiest, but congratulations to our top three. Thank you.
Our second highest average is one of Nicholas Stark. And the highest average for 8th grade math goes to Marlangia Jones. give our eighth grade round. Now for algebra one. The third highest average in algebra one goes to Nicholas Seabat.
Brother Fitz, thank you. Another big job. My meeting director slash secretary slash vice president, Avery Johnson. Treasurer, Lance Stone. I'm gonna take care of you. Mess your mind. And Kaden Jones. Thank you for your leadership. Thank you for helping to make baby better. I'm now thinking about my awards for academics. For social studies. The first is for world geography. Third highest. Thank you. No, that goes 97.2. World geography. Second highest. Jada Prince, 97.5. Thank you all so much, because I know sometimes I can get a lot of you. And I have to ask a question, that's why. Congratulations.
All right, this next award we're about to give out is the Citizenship Award. And this award is meant to recognize students who possess strength of character, our school or community leaders, promote citizenship and characteristics of good behavior. So, first up for citizenship, we have Ms. Keziah Kimball. Mr. Elijah Reginald. Ms. Dawson Durin. Mr. Nathaniel Wallace. Madison Cormack. Mr. Joshua Norwood. Ms. Natalia Williams. Ms. Mackenzie Watson. Ms. Brandy Day. Ms. Samaja Jones. Ms. Kaylee Cornelius. Ms. Jada Prince. Mr. Darian Bird. Ms. Marlena Johnson. Ms. Jayla Donaldson. Mr. Frederick Thomas. Ms. Alana Park. Ms. Mary Milnor. Ms. Corby Hughes. Brianna Miller. Mr. Savon Washington. Ms. Taylor Harris. Mr. Elijah George. Ms. Faith Nwabeka. Ms. Ella Jeffrey. Finally, Ms. Shelby Walker. Ladies and gentlemen, let's give one more round of applause for our students receiving the 56th award.
Good morning, everyone. I am Dr. Shea Gilmore. This is the principal of APAC, and it gives me great pleasure this morning to present the Presidential Gold and Silver Awards to our students. First, the Silver Award. Shatiya Adams. Recognize students who show outstanding educational growth, commitment to or and or intellectual development in your academic settings. We also have a letter from President Joe Biden. Thank you.
Tony Paulin. Zaniya Coleman.
Ladies and gentlemen, now it's time for our top 10 students of the
2022 8th grade class, Bailey Hemmings. These students will receive an award and also a donation of a gift card from our Bank First sponsor, our Bank First adopter. Let's give them a round of applause. Number 10. Jada Prince. Number 9. Madison Corbett. All of our top 10 around the world.
will be the Henry Spring Fellow Character Award. And before we begin, what is character? Character is what defines you. It's what people see in you. Character is one of the most important things you have. In the early years of the APAC, we had a coach named Henry Stringfellow. Coach Stringfellow embodied true character each and every day. He was always one of the first people to open up the building every morning and very often the very last person to leave late at night. Picture, if you will, a 6'6", 325-pound gentle giant. Coach Stringfellow was our hero. He never missed a day of work up until his passing. He always had a smile and was always willing to help everyone at a moment's notice. Coach Stringfellow was humble, kind-hearted, and very conscientious. We, the staff and family of Lady APAC, had to come up with a way to honor his memory. Hence, the Henry Stringfellow Character Award. Today's recipient of the Stringfellow Award embodies all that Coach Stringfellow stood for. This student is earnest, soft-spoken, humble, and very kind-hearted. The selection of this student was unanimous. Ladies and gentlemen, the 2022 Henry Stringfellow Character Award.
Thank you.
Camille Brown. Adriana Brown. Tanith Brown. Darian Bird. Veronica Caballero. Tony Conwell.
Thank you.
McGee. David McGee. Jeremiah McIntosh.
And once again, this is our eighth grade class, which is the graduating class of 2026. Let's give them a big round of applause. So we know, let's begin a few housekeeping things real quickly. We will be transitioning rather quickly when the students recess away. You should have already completed pre-dismissal forms, and it's like we already have those, correct? Okay, alright, I apologize for that. But we know how we're going to move out of here because, as I said, it'll be really quick. But just briefly, I just want to piggyback off Faith for this morning. She said, hey, we could go to space. Because all you need is somewhere to sit and learn. And that's what these scholars have done this year. You know, we've all come over a lot of adversities. We moved to Baby here at Northwest. We've accommodated each and every one of them. And as I told you at the beginning of the year, I looked at the vision and mission of both schools. We all are about the same thing, and that is educating our young scholars. And I told them the only difference for them this year would be they wouldn't be at 1900 State Street. They will be in class at 720 Highway 49 North. All of the teachers were the same. It was just in a different space, and that's what Faith said. So it doesn't matter the space that you're in. It's a matter of making the teachers teach you and you learning wherever you may be. When you move on to high school, I challenge you to continue to challenge your teachers. Make them teach you each and everything. Do not leave that classroom without a question unanswered. There's no such thing as a crazy question. The only crazy question is the question that is not asked. Make the teachers earn their paychecks. Make the teachers earn their paycheck. If you do not know, raise your hand. It's their job to teach each and every one of you. Parents, I would like to thank you for the dedication that you've shown to these scholars over the last 8 years, 8, 9, 10. We ask you to continue to support them in their endeavors moving forward. And also, as Shelby stated, history. You know your history, grow your history, and soon you will make history. All right? So without further ado, please rise as we prepare to exit our scholars.
Thank you.